then he retired and went in search of paradise.
Where's he live now, then?
Clacton.
Hell, I'll never got married. Not so much your principle. I think you were just dead jamming.
No, I'm not having that. There's more to not getting married than just staying single. If you want to not get married, then you've got to really work at it.
Well, he managed it.
Ah, yes. But Foggy has several natural advantages for not getting married. He has that bachelor shyness that we've all seen when he has to take his purse out and actually pay for it.
What's the fact? He's dead crackers. I'm prone to go leaping up steep hills like an excited brownie. Where the hell are we going? Hey, come in. Come in, mein Führer.
If you must do a hill climbing, Willis, couldn't you build yourself a racing pair?
What's wrong with him? I've got Willis all my civilian life.
I can tell they're the same damn pair.
Get off. There's plenty of mileage in these yet.
What's on the gallop anyway, Foggy? You're turning good human knees into chutney. Why have you got that purposeful glint behind your glasses?
I've got this idea. Yeah, well, it's more than an idea, really. I suppose you'd call it a vision. Oh, you can scoff. God only knows he can scoff. I've seen his sandwiches. But unless his soul is absolutely shriveled, not just his vest. When we get up there, you begin to see what I mean. The view, the grandeur, the valley spreading out beneath us, lacking only one thing, which we are going to supply. I don't think that's all that funny. Oh, come on, I know you're there somewhere. I try. God knows I try to raise the tone of our activities. Who introduced you to astronomy? Right? Who was it brought you out here in the hills one night and taught you how to navigate by the stars? You knew when they got a taxi back from Clacking. You'd just drift. You would. Well, he would. You know him. He drifts, you know he does. Like an oil slick straight for Norman and Compo. If it hadn't been for me, would either of you have enrolled for art classes this last winter? Well, you would have persisted. Things he could do with a bit of oxair pistol. Now, don't you think I've forgotten? I will never forget it.
Did you see her boots? She had no control over them boots.
No, can we just stick together and get a move on? You know, no more jolly japes. Let's call a halt temporarily to this let's make Foggy look abroad campaign.
You've hurt his rough feelings.
What about me?
Well, it's nice of you to inquire, but I feel all right. I'm more or less at peace with the universe. Except for this nagging suspicion that Foggy's in the grip of some enthusiasm again. Listen, whatever he's got lined up for us, we stick together, right?
Right.
Through thick and thin.
Through thick and thin.
Now what are you plotting?
It was him.
Is that a view?
You mean you don't know? You've brought us all this blamey way and you don't know?
It's times like this you wish you brought your other glasses.
Tell me, man, can't you enthuse a bit? I mean, look at it. It gets you here, doesn't it? It gets you right in here.
Where does it get you exactly, Foggy?
Here. Right in here, where my finger's pointing.
Oh, got it. Just to the left of the buckle on your braces, right?
I don't believe it. It must make you feel something.
I'm a shag.
I don't expect anything better from you, but come on, Clay. Look at all that magnificence spreading out there below you. What do you really think?
It's a heck of a walk, Noble Foggy.
Excitable, isn't it?
Does he always panic like this?
Beans and clips. Well, it looks like clips.
Order if you like, but you still get chips.
The beer will come in the hillside.
No singing. This establishment has no license for singing.
You got no license for shouting either, but that never stops the eye of it.
Or depressing, take your business somewhere else.
There isn't anywhere else.
Great, isn't it?
Where is the lady of the house?
She's out in front.
In a very big way.
No, you do not make personal remarks like that about people's wives.
I'm too old to change the
Forget that you haven't had the advantages of a commando training. Not one of you could kill with his bare hands. His bare feet, perhaps.
How far have you been?
I know we turned right at Yugoslavia.
All right. I was wrong. I overestimated your staying powers. I had you rated as slack and unfit. Whereas to reach that condition, you both have to go into hard training.
You've upset him this time.
Oh, I don't like to take all the credit. He's a tower of strength, upsetting wise.
Oh, no, you are kind.
It was just that I had this vision. Well, you know me, I'm an ideas man, you know, the old grey matter, always churning.
Over your brains, over your belly.
You see how it trivialises everything? My God, he's a challenge. But I shall rebuild him. We have the technology.
Come on, man, what was this vision?
I had this vision once. I'm a castaway on a desert island. An ocean comes slinking round from behind a coconut tree, but nor a magic. You see, I'd surprised her in the middle of one of these native festivals. Where she has to flick a duster over this little pot-bellied idol.
That'll be her husband, won't it?
There she stood in all her glory, wearing a sarong and a white camellia stuck into her curlers. Them rotten crinkled stockings, my house. Stockings.
Why don't you complain?
I do. I've said to her, Nora, you're never going to get anybody to grab your leg wearing stockings like that. It looks as though you've got haricot veins.
Will you sit down?
No, let him get on with it. I like it.
Don't encourage him.
He gets carried away.
God, I wish he would.
Well, there she stood in this jungle clearing. And I'm thinking to myself, Compo, you could be lucky. I wonder what she'll do for a few glass beads and a couple of trinkets.
Have you finished?
Aye, because that is all there is for public consumption. You see, as soon as she clapped eyes on me, she threw this flowered garland around my neck and then whispered passionately into my lobe, white man.
How long it is since you've been white?
Yes, well, what about this vision of yours, Foggy? You're going to tell us about it, aren't you?
It was just an idea. Well, no. No, to be precise, it was a superb idea.
Oh,
yeah. Well, I'm quite determined to carry it through to the end in spite of the quality of the help.
What is it?
That I, former Corporal Dewhurst, have a plan to put the perfect finishing touch to the great British landscape.
Oh, yes.
Isn't one better to put the perfect finish finishing touch to the great British landscape than the great British flag, the Union Jack.
He's crackers.
I'm a craftsman and a patriot, sir. If it is sighted with great artistry in just the right place, a work of art. But the idea came to me as a result of attending those winter art classes.
Are you trying to tell me that you went all through them art classes with that great lumpy bird sitting there starkers that we had to paint, and all you could think about were a flag?
The flag. My flag. Our flag. I'm not talking about something handkerchief size. I'm talking about something huge.
You see, he did notice that lady.
The biggest we can find at the top of a tall, proud flagpole of the kind which happens to be lying about abandoned at the back of what used to be the Sea Cadets Hut.
Listen, let me get this straight. Are you trying to tell me that when you lot went painting at night school, there was this nude model?
I thought my idea would capture your imagination.
Nude? I've never seen anything more nude in the life. It was all
right. You're quite right. He has never seen anything so nude in all his life. And at his age, I'll never have confidence he's going to stay that way. And you'll be in there all day talking filth.
I've only taken their orders.
Well, I hope you keep your pencil still. Because if I see another trembly handwriting, you're in trouble.
Your missus, she don't go much on nudity then.
You won't. Wasn't the occasional illustration in the coffee magazine. I'd still be under the impression that women were composed almost entirely of coarser material. I mean, to grab our ivy playfully, it's like feeling a lorry with an insecure load.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
What sort of illustrations did they have in the coffee magazine?
Well, they're all that in these days. Even the Poultry Keeper's Weekly.
No, man. That was a Rhode Island red dress ready for the oven.
Shows how long it is since I took any interest.
Well, what about this nude model in the art class?
I never looked. It was too embarrassing.
I looked.
Oh, yeah, we know you'd look.
I made the discovery that nude modelling makes me neck ache.
Why should nude modelling make your neck ache?
I spent 2 hours staring at the ceiling.
If it's quite true, I saw him. I thought he was peering underneath his glasses.
No way! I'd already borrowed his glasses.
What is this, sir? Grown men going to pieces at the thought of the naked human form?
Impression of a grown man going to pieces at the sight of the naked form. Cool.
Sit down. What is this thing in our background that won't let us be at ease with the undraped female form?
You know damn well what this thing is in my background. It won't let me be at ease with you.
What was that?
Your form, my precious, as in racing form.
Application form. Platform.
Yes, uniform.
Form rubber.
Sorry.
Well, I see you're all on form. Yeah, covering up for this big Tinkerbell.
I'm only taking the orders, love.
Well, come in here and take some of mine.
What's it going to be then, Les?
Sausage, beans and clips. 3 times.
Fully, very fully.
Well, it should be around here somewhere. It's a long pole with ropes attached.
We know what a flagpole looks like. Like thing without a cap.
Hands out of pockets, that man. Try and show a bit of enthusiasm. Time you stop giving this impression of a retarded dwarf. Now you, look for it over there. I'll take this section here. Look!
Foggy's found it.
Did you see that? The old instinct. The way the body rolls with the fall. Distributing the impact evenly throughout the base of the spine. I'm not as fit as I used to be.
Never was.
Are you sure you're all right? You seem to be getting your colour back. Lord knows what colour it is, but...
Yes, I'm all right. Just that I'm going to take me a standing for a while. Fancy leaving a damp flagpole lying about.
I don't suppose there's any chances there, Foggy, of you regarding this as an omen. Do you think it might be a little hint from the gods that we ought to abandon the whole scheme? I mean, great idea, but... we to defy the anger of the gods?
We don't crack it here the first little snap.
I do usually. Me too. I hear this voice that says, if at first you don't succeed, pack it in.
Get out of that end. Let's see how much weight we've got here.
It's been lying here for years. It could be a sacred sea cadet flagpole, bringing untold misfortune to any unbeliever who defiles it.
Oh, white men come in Nora's hut. Get out of that end. All right? Leap.
You are cruel. Hey, just a minute. How are we going to get this damn great look up that hill?
All right, don't panic. It's just a simple tactical problem we have to solve, that's all.
How?
I'm thinking about it. Have you got any suggestions?
Stick it up your mouth. While you've been arguing, I've been sitting here under this pole thinking, why doesn't somebody get me out from under this pole? I only mention this, A, because I can't move. Because it's damp under here. There seems to be every possibility of getting wood lice.
Lift.
Ever since I read some Harold Robbins, I've had this nightmare about wood lice in the trousers.
In the face. The solution is staring us in the face. That flagpole is too heavy to carry, therefore we need some transport. Logical thinking, right? Right? It is a swift military assessment of the situation. Shades of the old desert fox.
I need a chuffing helicopter. Are you going to get a hurry up that hill? Mein Führer.
How did we get guns up the hills in Italy during the war? Big, long, heavy guns. Not by lorry. By a much more primitive form of transport.
British rail.
Like a mule.
A mule?
Possibly two mules.
You mean those sort of reject horses they were like?
No, I mean mules. Extremely adaptable, very useful. Vicious, treacherous little animals. Oh, I know the way you come back, will you? But you think I hadn't planned for all that? I mean, give me a little bit of credit. You don't think Corporal Dewhurst is going to handle mules?
Oh, no, not for a minute. He'll be banking on finding a couple of dozy bullocks to do it for him.
You do? Oh, Pinky and Perky. Handle mules. Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Can we have that in writing?
If you want a skilled job doing, you've got to be an expert.
Who do we know who's an expert with mules?
Willis.
Willis?
Well, it's way past closing time. You ought to be leaving in a minute. Oh, speak of the devil. Here he comes now.
Send you out much further these days, Willis.
That new landlord. He always likes to do everything bigger and better than the last one did.
Why don't you change rooms, Willis?
Well, I'd be thrown out by strangers. Oh, no, I couldn't.
Can you walk, Willis?
No, I don't need to. I got bones.
Technical, but should somebody be driving this thing?
There is the horse. The horse knows where she's going.
Have you you still got those mules, Willis?
Not on me.
I'll keep you awake, will you? We might be able to come to some arrangement here.
How the hell can I keep him awake?
I keep irritating him like they do me.
He's so out of his mind.
That's a wicked rumor to start about anybody just because they keep falling down.
Lift his head up and let it drop back smartly.
Oh, charming. How long were you in the Gestapo, mein Führer?
Mules, Willis!
And you,
I still think somebody ought to be driving.
No. Leave it to the horse. The horse knows where she's going.
Why are we coming back to the pub, Willis? The pub, Willis.
You great, that stupid animal! And everybody that won't buy her pigs.
He's had a romantic life, has Willis, marrying that exotic, dark-eyed creature who taught him the 14 secret mind-blowing ways to cook your hedgehog.
Saying you won't.
He hasn't done much for Willis. I wouldn't know if I saw you. What's he look like, anyway?
Well, you remember that film Golden Earrings, where Marlene Dietrich played this great-looking gypsy?
Vaguely.
Well, don't remind Willis, he'll kill you.
I wonder if he's got anything for my back.
With a front like you've got, you should worry about your back.
How long have you been there? Now then, mules.
You see, Willis, I have this vision.
Play too, kiddo. Horrible little green things. Over the photo of younger Herbert's scrapyard that I keep on my bedside table as a reminder of where hard work can get you. Oh, my dear, that was last year. It's been much better since I cut down on that pole.
That's Blossom. That's Flower.
Right. They know who they are. Who's going to tell them who we are?
No problem. You see, you can handle them. They'll follow you anywhere.
Look, Willis, we'll come back when your legs are working better.
Oh, you stay where you are. If Willis is sure we can handle them ourselves, then we can handle them ourselves.
They're like a pair of kittens.
Why don't we start with a pair of kittens?
Don't you like to feel part of something worthwhile?
Don't you ever feel anything?
Apart from Scruffy.
I don't feel any parts after them mules. Sir?
Take this down.
Ah, yes, sir. Ready, sir?
To whom it may concern, this is to testify that since coming into contact with former Corporal Dewhurst, my life has been completely changed. He is, in my opinion, one of his generation's leading idiots, and I heartily recommend him to anyone in need of the same.
Come on, get a move on.
So, if you ever need a reference, Foggy...
I have all the references I require, thank you. Including one signed by Lieutenant Colonel, the Earl of Bridlington.
Zimbabwean Labour Exchange, the Earl of Bridlington.
An officer and a gentleman, a great Englishman. An institution as sound and as solid as... What is this? Throw a stone. That's a weak spot. There's a good job I noticed that, you know. Anyone with less sharp eyes to see what a molested couple there. I'm not alone now. I'm going to stand to attention for a while. I always feel better when I stand to attention for a while.
As part of UK TV Gold's Big Night In tonight, Liz Hurley and Brendan Fraser star in the hit movie Bedazzled at 9 o'clock. Next, here on Drama Daytime, though, the comedy is heaven sent.